Her Excellency, Ms. Arlet, Minister of Tourism and Environment Republic of Congo, His Excellency, Pak Erick Thohir, Executive Director of UN Environment, Mr. Jose Granger Funga, Director General of Forest and Personal Representative, His Excellency, Minister Emi, the Minister of Environment and Sustainable Development, Democratic Republic of Congo, Director General of CIFOR, Pak Robert, Ibu Tina from FAO, Ibu Dayana from GPI, Ibu Anita, UN Resident Representatives, Excellencies, all diplomatic colleagues, government officers, Dr. Agus Sistianto, Head of Research Development and Innovation of MOR, Head of Peatland Restoration Agencies, Pak Nazir Kuat, representatives from CSO, researchers, business leaders, community leaders, distinguished delegates, guests, ladies and gentlemen. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Shalom, Om Swastiastu. Good morning. It is my pleasure to welcome you all to this important event to launch the Environment Secretariat for an International Tropical Peatland Center, or the ITPC. First of all, let us thanks to Almighty God for His mercy upon us, pardon and deliver us from all our sins. Moreover, there are no words that will help take away the pain and sadness from such a horrific event of the accident of aeroplane yesterday morning. Prayer and thoughts for the families of the lost and to all members of the rescue personnel involved in the heartbreaking task of dealing with this dreadful situation. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, as you may be aware, tropical peatlands are found in more than 80 countries, yet they remain among the least understood and monitored ecosystems in the world. Storing 30-40% of global soil carbon deposits on only 3% of the world's land surface. Tropical peatland ecosystems are the key component for mitigating climate change and so crucial to preserve firm from destruction and degradation. Indonesia has quite long experience in managing its over 15 million hectares of peatlands. This went back to early in the last century when local tribes in Kalimantan had managed peatlands in a sustainable manner for subsistence purposes. The next period was the extensive peatlands utilization era starting the 1970s. Mostly for timber plantation and agricultural estates, and under private concession, in particularly after 1990, mostly for also timber plantation and agricultural estates. That these were known to have degraded quite a significant area of peatlands. The present era can be labeled as the corrective era. That Indonesia is confident the world acknowledged Indonesia's peatland management as internationally recognized within a short period of time of 3 years since 2015. Of course, there has been a lot of work and energy contributed, and in particularly the national leadership of Indonesia under President Jokowi. I remember during the very hard time in September-October 2015, President Jokowi gave his direction to ministers immediately while in the field observation and during our field work several times in 2 months in Sumatra and Kalimantan right that year. This is proving that field work and field research is good for decision making as it gives a real picture to the sites and the situations to solve the forest fires and peatland management problem so that sound decision can be made. As you may recall, during the Paris talk in December 2015, when we had CIFOR forest fire problems in Sumatra and Kalimantan, President Jokowi promised to have big corrective action. And he gives his promise to the world, as we can see now within 3 years of the implementation. The corrective era, among others, we have strengthened the moratorium of new licenses and the improvement of primary forests. And we conduct peatland governance. The policy has been strictly enforced by issuance of new regulations, including on protection and management of peat ecosystem, measurement of water table in peat ecosystem, certainly recovering peat ecosystem functions, the force dealing with burn area within production forest concession, industrial plantation forest on peat lands controls, peat hydrological and ecosystem, and peatland ecosystem and function mapping. These regulatory measures are accompanied by strong enforcement, as described by over 500 legal cases post the 2015 fires, including a historic $1.2 billion fine. The 3 licenses are revoked, 16 licenses are freezed, and 115 being forced for improvement, and 335 is under intensive control and supervision. The results are dramatic. The forest and fires in 2018 decreased. Number of hotspots decreased by 89%, and area burned decreased by 93%. That is 2.6 million hectares in 2015, and becoming 194,000 hectares in 2018. It is good that Indonesia managed the forest fire for Asian Games in August and September, which actually is the peak period of fire. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, with this shift of paradigm, Indonesia intends to take more proactive roles in the international effort to sustain the world's forest ecosystem, including peatlands, and to implement the Sustainable Development Agenda. Have we learned from emerging environmental challenges? We have improved our capacity to address the problems, prepare stakeholders to understand the problems better, mitigate the impacts, do the adaptation, and control the source of the problem. Indonesia is ready to join the growing movement of pay more attention to sustainable peatland management, such as pushed forward by the Global Peatland Initiative, international peatland societies, and so on. We are keen to share our experience so that fellow countries do not have to reinvent the wheel. Such fellow countries may be the Congos, both the Republic and the Democratic Republic, who have just recovered their significant peatland areas relatively recently. This is why I am very pleased to have the esteemed guests from the 2 Congos, as well as from various international organizations, along with the diplomatic corps in Jakarta. I see this as a positive response from international community for what we are doing today, that is to initiate the establishment of an international tropical peatland center. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, we recognize the need for some credible and legitimate information, analysis, and tools to design and implement conservation and sustainable management of tropical peatlands. Therefore, the center should seek to make effective, cost-efficient, and equitable solutions more readily available, create the necessary enabling conditions for good policy, support national goals for sustainable development and climate mitigation and adaptation, and provide international visibility to the participants. facilitating partners and multiple donors successfully addressing peatland conservation, restoration, and management to the benefit of people and the local and global environment. In the spirit of international, multi-stakeholders, and multi-donor social cooperation, the center is to be built on the principle of true cross-sector collaboration and integration, building a resilient and holistic platform for science, policy and practice, and attracting the best minds working on research and practice in this field. The center will support current initiatives but bring a new, distinctly science-based approach to the dialogue. As a physical entity, it will crystallize a home base for global tropical peatland science, sustain policy debates, capacity building efforts, international coordination, and strategy development for tropical peatlands. For that purpose, the center should be based at the two forest research campuses in Bogor, Research, Development, and Innovation Agency, as well as Center for International Forest Research, CIFOR. I am glad that most of the distinguished international guests here visited the two campuses yesterday. I am also glad that the international guests visited West Kalimantan to see the practice of sustainable management of tropical peatlands. That should include industrial planting, peatland conservation, peatland conservation, water management, monitoring of the table, hydro buffer, hotspots monitoring, and combating forest fire. It might have been observed in the field that sustainable peatland management does not only involve government, but all stakeholders, including local communities, global societies, and the private sector. I do recognize that public-private partnership should be promoted in order to accelerate achievement of our major agenda. I hope that I have described for you the background of what we are doing today towards an international tropical peatland center. Lastly, I thank you to the UN Climate Consortium for all of the direction, colleagues, my best friend Minister Arlai, Minister Emmy and DG Jose, and all CIFOR and all parties that make the Secretariat of ITPC launch and would be and could be working together with us and with all countries. I thank you for your kind attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you very much.